arrives in theaters to beat up the competition, and here is a sneak peek.
Thought I might ask you a few questions. Tell me about the White Rose.
You must be Daddy's little girl.
So that's what happens when they go to the bathroom together. Nice to know. Joining me now, the star of Street Fighter, the legend of Chun-Li, Kristen Kreuk is here. How are you? How are you? Everything all right?
Yes, I'm doing.
Can we get you anything? Fresca?
No,
you good?
I'm good.
Okay, good. I have never, I told you this right before the interview, but I have never had so many people come up and say, oh my God, you have to meet her. She's the nicest, sweetest thing in the world. You're in the wrong business, is what I'm saying. Like, how?
Oh, really?
Yeah, how do you manage to be feature film star, huge Smallville star, and yet stay so sweet and grounded?
I don't know. I think that it's just a choice. I think that you can, you know, be an ass if you want to be an ass, but you don't have to be. Yeah,
but if you choose to be, it's entirely okay.
Yeah. If you want to be an ass, be an ass. Yeah.
So the Street Fighter movie, by the way, nicest bathroom ever for a nice karate fight to break out.
It's a beautiful set.
Where was that at? Where?
We shot it in Bangkok in Thailand, so that was just on a stage.
Wow. Well, how long were you over there for?
3.5 months.
Oh, was this a good experience?
Yeah, it was amazing. Bangkok's crazy. I worked a lot, so I didn't get to see a lot of it, but it's hot and it's smelly and there's tons of people.
Oh, sounds fancy. Put it on a pamphlet. Sign me up for that. Hot and smelly, Expedia, hello.
Hot and smelly, please.
But I didn't see Jean-Claude Van Damme in that clip. And how do you have a Street Fighter film without Jean-Claude?
Well, we managed to do it. He's pretty incredible, Jean-Claude.
Yeah. Did he just show up and split jump for you guys and you're like, okay, thanks, Jean?
That would have been radical. I'd love it if he did.
But no Jean-Claude.
No Jean-Claude.
That's okay. Because we have Chun-Li, which is great. Did you wear the Chun-Li outfit? Did you?
Well, what you saw there is the closest to the Chun-Li outfit that we get, which is good for me because the Chun-Li outfit, we were just talking about it before, is like slit up to here and like big buns and you can't find
that. Where's
the
problem with that?
For you, there's probably not.
No, there's absolutely not. I'm totally okay with that.
Imagine if you were wearing the outfit and you were fighting people
in it. You're talking to the wrong guy, actually, because I, French maids, I'll do Chun-Li,
like
it's fine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, if it's for the show, of course. You played Lana Lang in Smallville for so many years. Did that help you at all get ready for this role? I don't remember any high-speed kicking action.
I did a little bit of wire work on Smallville, so I had the experience of being in the air like that, but this was totally...
Was there a ton of wire work on this one? Or?
There was a ton of wire work on this one,
and
yeah.
Is it, so, okay, so you're incredibly rigged.
I haven't seen any of this stuff.
Oh, yeah, there you go. You may be there. I love that it's a barrel roll with a smile.
That's very mean.
No, that's great. I know you're a gymnast, right?
Yeah, so, ex-gymnast, yeah.
So this came really naturally for you then?
To a degree. I mean, it's still hard to make this look great. Dion Lam is an amazing teacher. He's the stunt choreographer, and he's great. But it's hard.
You had such a rabid fan following on Smallville, but now that's in the past. That's all done. There's no more.
Yeah, I'm done. I've moved on.
Tear. Collective nerd tears across the country.
I think that it was time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With a fan base from One Like Smallville, I imagine they're pretty rabid. Are they following you online and emailing you constantly, harassing you when you come out of Mr. Chow's? Like, how crazy are they?
Because I go to Mr. Chow's all the time. It's a strong fan community. You know, fanboys are like, they're dedicated to their you know, comics or games or whatever it is, which I totally understand. So it's not too crazy, but it's really easy to access me sometimes.
Sure. But does it get crazy enough to where you have to use fake names and create aliases when you travel around?
I do use an alias when I travel around, yes.
Oh, okay. I'm not going to ask you to reveal it because
that
would kind of ruin the entire thing. But I mean, how do you come up? Do you sit down and say, let's come up with something fun, something silly? Were there potential aliases that you didn't go with?
Well, I started when I was younger with like Jane Eyre. And then I moved on to something, and I was sitting down one day, and I was like, what could be the funniest, most incongruous name that I could think of? And that's what I decided on.
Okay, very good. What's the porn star name? Like the first pet in the street you grew up on? Do you have that?
Because that's what I was Mischief Yukon. It's pretty good, right?
That's actually really good. That's actually really damn good. Mr. Neutron, okay. We're totally out of time, but Caper 219 wants to know what you're doing tomorrow night.
Caper 219.
Yeah, so the viewer sent this in. He wants to know what you're doing. P.S. Kevin, you're awesome. Thanks, dude. Really appreciate that. It says it right there. It's totally on the card.
Right.
So, are you busy?
Maybe, yeah. I think
that's it. Oh, P.P.S.
Sorry,
enjoy your weekend alone playing Street Fighter the video game, Kevin. Awesome. Thanks, Caper. You know me too well. Kristen, always a pleasure. Thank you so much for coming on. I wish you the best of luck at the film.
Thank you, so much.
You guys, Street Fighter, The Legend of Chun-Li opens in theaters next Friday. Right now, we're going over to Olivia, who's about to deliver her own series of The Thousand Rending.